Hi, it's Nikki here from Happy Hormones for Life, and today I am talking about phytoestrogens and how they can help improve your menopause symptoms. If you're looking for an alternative to HRT or you're just wanting to manage your symptoms naturally, phytoestrogens could be your new best friend. They are natural plant compounds that are structurally similar to human estrogen, and they can mimic the action of estrogen in the body. So it's particularly useful in menopause. By including them in your diet, you can kind of trick the body into thinking you've got some circulating estrogen going on and reduce many of the symptoms associated with falling levels like hot flushes, night sweats, and all the other symptoms that we get from low levels of estrogen. Now, what foods are we looking at that contain these plant-like phytoestrogens? Well, there are many types of phytoestrogens, but the most significant for menopause symptoms are the isoflavones. Most commonly found in the soybean, which is soy products, lignans in things like flax seeds. So those are the two that have the most kind of dense nature or quantity, if you like, of phytoestrogens in them. They are much less potent than estrogen you'd get from your HRT. But research does show that they can help soothe menopause symptoms and also protect against things like heart disease, osteoporosis, and dementia. And they may also help lower your risk of hormone-related cancers. Some of the research out there is showing this. So how do they work? Well, they work by latching on to your estrogen receptors. And by doing that, they're having an estrogenic effect, helping to balance levels in the body. And their behavior depends on your biological levels of estradiol, which is your main estrogen. So if levels are high, they can regulate them, and this can help with things like PMS or heavy or painful periods, and help to manage the risk of estrogen-driven conditions like fibroids and endometriosis. Equally, as estrogen levels start to drop at menopause, phytoestrogens actually can help them stay at a certain level, increase them naturally. And this can help ease symptoms like the hot flushes, night sweats, and protect against things like osteoporosis, memory loss, heart disease in the long term. So natural phytoestrogens are actually the body's preferred source of estrogen next to naturally produced forms. So that means they're going to beat things like toxic estrogens that we can get in chemicals, endocrine disrupting chemicals in our environment. And this is really good news, but you still need to make sure you're eating a nutrient dense diet, getting lots of rest and relaxation, and maintaining your hormone balancing exercise plan as well, and making sure you're not overly exposed to these hormone disrupting chemicals. So all of the happy hormone code that I cover a lot, eat, rest, cleanse and move, needs to be still done alongside incorporating some of these plant estrogens into your diet. What are the benefits of these phytoestrogens? There have been many, many studies on them, and benefits include reduced hot flushes, preventing bone loss, regulating cholesterol levels, normalizing blood sugar levels, glucose levels, helping regulate the menstrual cycle, helping prevent estrogen-dependent cancers, and improving brain fog and memory loss as well. So there's lots of benefits that have been studied. How to include them in your diet? Like I said, there's two main sources. So soy is really, really important to avoid any genetically modified soy. We don't want that going in because that's just going to stress the body out. So we want unprocessed, unsweetened, organic soy where possible. Good brands are things like Sojade. I don't know if you say that, but that's how I say it. Provermel is a good one as well. And you can, you know, try organic unsweetened soy milk. That's really great to have in your tea or coffee. On your breakfast or whatever. You can try organic soy natural yogurt, but don't go for the fruity ones because you're getting loads of sugar in there. Add your own fruit, like berries are really good for things like that. And then organic tofu and tempeh, which is the fermented form of soybean. And then edamame beans are great. And miso is lovely too, because it's miso paste. It tastes kind of savory. You can add it to your cooking. It's a little bit marmitey. So that's unami taste. Have I said that right? Anyway, you know what I mean. So if you're intolerant to soy, some people are, it can cause some gut issues. If you do have a sensitivity to soy, please don't eat it. and you can always get it, the isoflavones, from supplements. So if you're not, then try some soy on your diet and see what happens. Flax seeds are the next best source of phytoestrogens. And flax seeds have a double whammy benefit because they're not only full of phytoestrogens, they're also really good for your gut, so they help the bowel move properly. So And they're full of fiber, they're full of nutrients, they've got lots of good things about them. So flax seeds, or linseeds as they're called if you buy them whole, you really want to eat them ground or milled, because the whole seeds tend to just go straight through and you don't get the benefit. So you can buy milled or ground flax seeds, keep them in the fridge once you've opened them because they are quite volatile. A good brand I like is Linwood's. They do lots of mixtures of different seeds, so that would be a good way to get them in. And I would go for like 1 to 2, start at 1 tablespoon and then you can build up to 2 if you want to try more. You can sprinkle them on your yogurts, put them in your smoothies, make some flaxseed crackers, they're amazing. I've got a recipe for that I can link to you. Sprinkle on salads or into soups or in your cooking, because they're quite tasteless on their own, so you can just throw them everywhere. Other sources of phytoestrogens, they're much less in quantity, but chickpeas and hummus, sesame seeds, pumpkin seeds, legumes, dried apricots, alfalfa sprouts, mung beans, rye bran, there are a few others. And there is some good news as well, that dark chocolate has some phytoestrogens in it. Yes! So another benefit for the dark chocolate. There's nothing wrong with it, it's all good. Magnesium, antioxidants, and now phytoestrogens as well, albeit quite a small amount. So don't just use that as your main source. Now, if you can't get enough phytoestrogens in your diet, supplements can help. There are quite a few aimed at the menopause market. It can be quite confusing. So I do have a link. Go and check out my recommended brands that are under the menopause section on my page. And then you can just see all the ones that we use in clinic that we like. So if that helps you, then please go and make use of that. And if you need any personalised help whatsoever, do contact us to find out more about our one-to-one support and our testing. I hope you found that useful today. Have a great rest of the week. See you soon.